What is up, guys? Dakota here with part, I think, 10 of Mafia 3's Let's Play walkthrough. And now we're about to do the Burke missions. I'm not sure I'm going to split these ones up, if I'm going to do the same as Vito's, or I'm just going to all pack it into one to two videos. But hopefully, it won't be too long. We can get really far into the story again when we get all three of them people now. And we can really do some work against the Italian Mafia in New Bordeaux. But anyways, let's get to it, guys. I've already got us here and everything, so now we just gotta go in there and talk to Burke and see if we can get him to help us. Okay, we gotta go to the back door.
Burke. Been a while.
Lincoln Clay. He's just Christ on the cross. Now it's in everything. Heard you were dead.
Been hearing that a lot.
The fuck do you want?
Came here to make you a business proposition.
Is that so?
I'm going after Marcano, his brothers, anyone else that's associated with him.
You want my help?
The way I see it, once we deal with Barbieri, you get Point Verdun back. After that, we can discuss what happens to the rest of the city.
No, fuck off. Vault your chalky bastard once already. Look where I got me.
From where I'm standing, I'm not seeing much of a difference between then and now.
You listen, that you listen, God, you fuck. Danny was so buttoned up, the coroner wouldn't let me get a last look. Anyone's killing that fucking Marcano. That's me.
Unless Marcano's hanging around one of these dive bars, I don't think he has too much to worry about.
Yeah, go fuck yourself. Rub our stones in the legs of you, they're a fucking off. Fucking great. Come and put your question me. You and your kind, you cut and run at the first sign of trouble. You always have. You always will. Fucking keys.
Oh, wow. Let's try this one more time. If I didn't, if I cut it out, what happened is that I died.
What the Christ you think you're doing?
You were bragging about your stones, so I figured we'd take a little ride. See who cracks first. The Chalky or the Mick?
And I'm about to do the same thing that killed me the first time because I think it'll actually help the best.
Give me the word when you've had enough.
Oh, yes! This is kind of hard, actually, because okay. This, I might be able to get us up now. Almost hitting cars is, like, what I've noticed to be, like, one of the best things to do. Now I'm running out of cars. There we go, come on, come on, come on. Right here's perfect.
All right. You proved your point, you mongoose.
Pull over here. Now, get the fuck out of my ride.
Me shop. We could talk business there.
And that's how you scare a drunken Irishman. I don't want you. I want the car behind you because this is look like a bus, a bad car. This is actually a nice looking car. Okay, I'll see you guys when we get there to start a nation once again. See you guys then. Okay, guys, we are here. So let's continue with Burke's missions. He lives in the trash. You notice, gotta find out how to get in. Is that a door? There it is.
Back so soon then?
Tell me about Barbieri.
Barbieri? He's a right fucking cunt. I can tell you that much.
You know what I'm asking, Burke. Give me something I can use.
Barbieri's running Splough out of the Sweetwater Distillery.
Splough?
Panther's piss. White Mule? Ollie Gin? Potchain? Moonshine? You ignorant fuck? Christ, what kind of booze you people drink over there in Darkyville?
Kind is not called painter's piss.
Boy, you ain't lived. Set the whole thing up myself. And that gunny fuck comes in, takes it from me. Smashes me knee all to hell. Barbieri's gonna suffer. You hear? Days. Slow.
What else has he got besides the distillery?
Aye, runs that old Robert O. Slaughterhouse. He's doing more in there than cutting a lean ribeye. Drags in there. That's the end of you.
I'll do the heavy lifting on this, Burke.
Uh-huh.
But once Barbieri's dead, I'm counting on you to step up.
I'll do more than step up. And I'll be running this whole damn town or burning it to the ground. But honest, it'll make a whole lot of difference to me either way. A nation, come on, once again. A nation once again. And Ireland long, a province be a nation once again.
What is up, guys? Dakota here with Psychotic Gaming. Sorry for the weird transition, but we are starting Portland Verdun, the Blade Stained Red Moonshine, where I gotta talk to Nikki Burke. So, start a morning here.
Lincoln, over here.
Surprised to see you, Nikki.
I know what you're planning on doing, and I couldn't just sit here and watch my old man send you out half-cocked. Fuck.
Well, your dad's never been much for details.
Yeah, what he didn't tell you is that the man running the Sweetwater Distillery is named Carl Bevers. Hard ass. Country asshole. His family runs the shine through the business, sells it to local shops.
Bevers ever let on to where he keeps his stills?
He's got brains enough to move things around. Rumor is, he's got a map hid somewhere for his drivers.
Something like that could come in handy. Maybe I'll convince one of his men to tell me where it is.
Hey, we've got another man, goes by the name of Bear, keeping an eye on the meatpacking plant. You should go see him.
I'll do that. Thanks for the help.
Anytime, Lincoln. You want to know what Bevers is up to, you're gonna have to get at some of his people.
Okay, let's see what we gotta do for these ones. Talk to Bear Donnelly. Nikki wants the moonshine record back into the family. I guess we gotta head right here. Okay, guys, I will see you when we get there. Peace. What is up, guys? We're back. I finished all the side quests for this one and this one, so we can go ahead and get done. I'm already here at this one, so I'm gonna go ahead and talk to Nikki, see what she needs now.
Bevers can't be happy about what you've been doing.
You are the best thing to ever happen to me. I don't give a damn what anyone says.
The distillery's business.
Except.
You got Carl's attention. He's back at the Sweetwater Distillery.
Any idea how he'll react when I go in there?
He's bug shit crazy swamp people. How do you think he'll react? Still, might be worth keeping him around. No one knows the bayou like he does.
Owe you one for this, Nikki.
Damn right you do. Bevers is waiting for you. Real interested to see how you handle him.
I will see you guys then. Okay, guys, we are back and we're at the distillery.
There's a my neck is standing up.
Come here, little buddy. Gonna take you out real fast. Dead.
don't know the... Oops. Ah, here's the door. Might be smart to take this one. Sorry if I'm being quiet during these times, guys. I get like really into this and really focused. And you gotta be really during these things. Never take any chances.
Okay, this is not the way to go. That's not the way to
go. Coming through. Okay.
Is he gonna come down here? Oh, he is. But wait, there's another dude over there. Yeah, he's just gonna keep his mouth shut. He knows what's up. Go ahead and get this guy coming this way. Should be able to take him out real fast.
I don't think they breathe.
Well, guys, I think we've pretty much completed this whole mission in stealth. Haven't gotten spotted.
What's the bug up your ass? Most of that shine we lost belonged to us. Try and pull some up on the area.
That dead-eyed fucker will find out. Meaning he'll come after not just you and me.
Am I crazy, or did you catch that too?
Kids, everybody. No, we gotta get ahead of this. And fuck Bark!
You talk too much.
And that's how you do it, guys.
When his father fled Ireland, likely because of his involvement in the Irish Civil War. After his father died of a heart attack, Burke started running booze to support himself. I mean, he turned bootlegging into an entire industry, and Sal Marcano took notice. Burke worked his way up the ranks, but could never be made because he wasn't Italian.
Hey, we're here, guys. Let's do it, guys. Let's go. No, I'm thinking about putting all of the Burke's missions in one video. Where is it, though?
You bet. Nikki sent me.
Oh, I'm gonna marry that girl someday. Bear Donnelly. I own Nikki's dad. Everything. He has me keeping an eye on the Robert O. meatpacking plant.
Who's running things over there?
Nut job by the name of Sonny Blue. Lets a room out to the butcher's loan sharks. Protection guys, too. If they can't do it there, they put the hurt to people in the street.
Any chance Sonny's around the Robidoux?
Fuck no. Sonny only comes around to scare his people into shape. But I'm hearing one of his boys, a fella named Ralph, got caught skimming. They're working the bloody bastard over in the slaughterhouse to find out where he's got it stashed. Might be beneficial to pull his arse out of the fire.
I'll see what I can get out of Sonny's goons. Watch your ass, Bear.
Sonny Blue's people are scared of him. Might not talk. Why not make him more scared of you?
Where in hell, lady?
Okay, guys, well, you know what happens when I gotta get money down and everything. I only gotta get 20,000 down. His are actually really easy compared to the rest of them, but I will see you guys when I do finish these. What's up, guys? Okay, we're back. We just finished the other Point Verdun mission. We're about to do the final one before we do the main storyline one, so let's get to it, guys.
No one's paying up the Sonny Blue. It's really fucked him up with the... Butch, Sonny's back over at the Robert O. His language has taken an especially colorful turn of late.
I take it the butcher didn't appreciate Sonny's loan sharking and protection rackets being disrupted.
You got that right. And the Shinola has hit the fan. Sonny set on getting things back to normal. You know, keeping his people more scared of him than you.
We'll see about that. Keep your head down till this is over, hear?
I hear Sonny's a bit pissed at some mysterious colored fella disrupting his business. Even went all the way down to the meatpacking plant to wait for him.
Don't know why people don't like the rain.
Okay, guys, I will see you when we get there. Peace. Okay, guys, we already started a little bit into this. Give me 1 second. There we go. Sorry if you guys heard that. I'm already in the plan. I've already taken out a guard or two. Just taking him out slowly because we're going to get to Sonny Blue, and then that'll be the end for the... Oh. I saw the gimpy motherfucker Burke yesterday, was staggering down the sidewalk, piss all over the front of his pants. I know Mr. Barretti says we're not to touch that Irish fuck, but I so want to take a bat to his other leg, cripple him up good. That's harsh.
The whole Saint Down crew's just gone. Fuck.
Hoo-hoo. Woohoo! Huh? Uh-oh. This guy must be the very farther end, though.
Huh? Am I crazy, or did you catch that, too?
Yeah, get him up. I think it's gonna be two we get away. Okay, I see some two or three more in the back.
Running for cover! You know what that butch is gonna do to me?
Should've never fucked with Irish Point.
Oh my god.
Slaughterhouse is clear. Send your people.
Hey, don't worry about the bodies. My boys will know what to do about them. Everything's in place. The butcher's on his way. Time to put that rabid dog down.
Lincoln Clay convinced Thomas Burke, Vito Scaletta, and the woman known as Cassandra to work together.
He called a sit-down. He told them to meet him at an old plantation house in the bayou. When he had them all in the same room, he laid out how they were going to take down Marcano. Lincoln could be very persuasive.
Okay, guys, that's going to be it for this whole episode. Hope you guys enjoyed the 10th episode. The 11th episode will consist of killing Thomas Burke, and maybe when we go to the plantation house to lay down the plan and everything, and then we'll really get kickstarted on taking down the mafia. Hope you guys enjoyed. I'll see you guys later. I love you guys. Later. Peace.